Today, Rob is going to explain the backhoe reverser replacement project. If you want to skip around, the chapter timestamps are in the description section down below the video. The backhoe broke down on the night the outside of the shop was finished. We didn't even have doors on the shop then. The inside of the shop was mostly a big lake, and our lighting was horrible, so that first video that we did was really subpar. We hope this one is a better explanation and gives you that information you're looking for to fix your shuttle shift transmission repair. Boy, I can't say that fast twice.
Try to explain here what has to be done in order to get the reverser out. Okay, some of the first thing that has to be done is the short shaft has to be taken out. It just slides out of here. You got two bolts on each side of that shaft has to come off. Then the drive shaft for the front end, it has to slide off. You have two bolts the same way holding it on. This cover should come off to drain the reverser. Then you have these hoses here. You have a sending unit up here. This hose here is the filler and the dipstick. It has to come off. Then these hoses off the side either have to come off or be turned. These hoses here has to come loose. It has to be pushed over a little bit in order to get the bell housing passed. We have four bolts on the bell housing. One here. The other one is right up in here someplace. Then you have to do something. Either use a jack or a come along with a chain up around the frame underneath the motor, because you have to take this bolt out right here, which is a motor mount, and then you have this bolt over here, which is another motor mount. Get a light in there so you can see a little better. Those have to come out. When you take those bolts out, the motor will drop, so you have to chain the motor up so it doesn't come down. And show this other one over here. Okay, when you get those four bolts out, then you have six bolts on the reverser that have to come out here. And then I believe there's two up on top that you have to get at that are kind of hard. And over here, these are the solenoids. There should be two, I believe, for the forward and reverse. They're just put together with two connections. Those two have to come off. This is what I had to change. This came with the wrong style when I bought the reverser. So this whole bracket had to come off, be changed, the valves inside and everything. I believe I show a little bit of that in the video. That's pretty much it. Once you get the reverser started coming down, there's the reverse switch on top, which basically runs the back alarm, and the neutral switch. If that neutral switch is not in the right place, the engine won't run. So that signals, if it's in reverse, why you can't start it. So it has to go into neutral. That, I think, is basically where it has to come out. If you don't watch real close, this big hose, which is the hydraulics for the whole engine, or in the all of the apparatus, the bucket, the backhoe and everything, to take it off and get it out of the way in order to get to some of those upper bolts. Once the bell housing's off, there's a plate in here that bolts to the flywheel, and then the torque converter bolts to it. That's what makes it solid to the flywheel to get your everything to spin. Once that big line, you have to watch once it comes off, why you're going to get a lot of fluid come out of there. So if you have a way to drain the tank beforehand, it would be better. Kind of see this hose here. I think it had to come off also. I had to do something with it to get this ear past the... You really have to watch the wiring and the hoses when you get ready to pull it out. This hose here has to be a non-collapsible. This has wire inside it. Makes it real hard to tighten up so that it doesn't leak. The same on the front end down there where it hooks onto the pump. That's the hydraulic pump up there.
I have the reverser out on the portable shop truck bench. I'm taking the fittings all out. You want to make sure you either remember or have a drawing on which way they face, because when you put them back in, they got to be pretty close to right and you don't have much room to work. putting in a pipe plug now, or a bushing, so that one of the other crossover tubes will work. You want to use a pretty good pipe dope. This is stuff that came from North Dakota. We used on the pipelines and on our trucks for oil when we had to replace fittings. It's a special stuff that's good for petroleum products. If you use pipe tape, you want to make sure you get the yellow and not the white. The yellow is good for petroleum products also, but I don't like it as well as the regular dope. Just attaching all the pipes and fittings and crossover tubes onto the new reverser from the old one. This here is a switch that it's basically a reverse switch to let the transmission know you're in reverse, but it also runs the backup alarm, and it's connected to the computer or whatever in there some way, so that if you're not in, if you're in gear, it will not let it start. When we were putting the reverser back in, it broke one of the ears off that switch, so it would not tell the computer what was happening. I tried soldering it back on, but evidently got too hot and fried it. So I called John Deere, and they said either try shorting the two wires across or pulling them off of the switch. One way or the other should have made it work, which it did. I just took a wire off, and it went ahead and went into gear, which breathed a sigh of relief for me. Not quite sure what the sending unit on top of that T I just put in was, but I think maybe it had something to do with the, let you know what the pressure is. I'll talk a little later, but there's three parts of this shaft that I'm cleaning that have to be lined up. Here, this is the control valve. It's two electric solenoids over a hydraulic valve, and that's what runs the forward and the reverse. The new part had the wrong housing on it. You can see me here. I'm taking those are electric solenoids that are coming off, which make the valve work. And then the valves on the inside, I'm taking them out, which I didn't need to do because this whole piece had to go on to the new reverser. The old reverser had different size ports for those valves to screw in, and the valves were too big and they wouldn't go in. So I guess basically all I'm doing here is taking the valves out, making sure they're clean, then I'll be putting them back in the same housing and then having to put that housing on the reverser that's going back in the backhoe. Just trying to get these valves cleaned up a little bit. Make sure the O-rings are all good. Don't want to put it back in there and have them leak. You see, I was taking the cap out. This is where I decided the valves are too big to go in the refurbished block, so I had to put the block off the old reverser on there and put the valves and solenoids back on it. Here I'm just trying to clean out these two holes. I made a bracket to go on the back to hold the reverser on the floor jack. So I'm cleaning the holes out so I can do the bolts real easy, turning them by hand instead of having to use a wrench. Now I'm taking the U-joint brackets off the yoke of the old one. they'll be on the new ones when I put it back in, while the drive lines will set down in, and then I can put the other bracket on. Putting the number of the reverser on it, in case we have to get parts in the future, won't have to look for it. First arrow is inside the seal. There are two ears on the torque converter that are opposite each other, and they go inside that seal. They have to line up, otherwise you'll break something. So I tried to put both of them at 9 o'clock and 3 o'clock, because you can't see anything once you get it up there. The second arrow is a solid center shaft. It also has to line up with the torque converter, and it doesn't move, so that's where you have to rock the reverser. Center shaft slides into the reverser, and the reverser turns it, which makes the wheels go around. Here we have trying to get it up and get it close to the bell housing. You put the torque converter on the plate on the flywheel, then the torque converter to that plate, and then the bell housing goes in. I am trying to get the jack to where it'll slide. It's sitting on a piece of plywood on rough ground, so it doesn't want to slide very good. So I end up hooking a quarter ton come along to the front axle and the front of the jack, so I can just slowly come along it into place. You also have to jack it up and down in order to get the shafts fairly well centered, so they'll start in the torque converter. I've gotten it in. I only can get it in about another half an inch, about an inch and a quarter there, but I'm trying to get everything lined up. But I just cannot get it to go in by myself. It needs to be rocked. In my old age, I'm just too weak to manhandle it. So I called a friend that I mechanicked with, and on his way home from Finky's shop, he stopped and helped me. Situations like this, they usually pop right in easy when somebody else tries it, which happened. We got in there and took the bracket off the back, rocked it a little bit, fell right in place, took about a minute and a half. I'd probably fought it for 2 hours. There are two adjustments on the transmission jack. You can see the wheel in the front there. That tips it forward and back, and then there's another wheel on the side to tip it sideways. You want to make sure you try and get that thing lined up just as close as you can to being level going in there. It saves a lot of fighting later on. The arrow shows where I put the chain across from the frame underneath the motor to the frame when I took it apart to hold the motor up. I like the chain better, because if you put a jack and a block under there, then you're trying to wiggle around it and it gets in your way. The first thing that goes on is there's a plate that goes to the flywheel and bolts on, and then the torque converter bolts to the plate. Then you can go ahead and put the bell housing on, which has the motor mount bolts, and get it up into place and get it bolted on. And then you can start putting the reverser back in.